This flowchart is an example of a decision structure. Decision structures are created using if statements. If something happens, you do one thing. Otherwise, you do something else. Often that else is nothing. And you can have this represented simply as a single-sided if. But I'm just trying to show here that we're waiting for the mouse to be pressed. If somebody presses the mouse, we'll draw a circle. To close the window is how we end the program. So we're really sitting here, if the window closes, it will end. So this is the other way to show the same structure, because there really is nothing happening in the no side. So I'm showing it here, I'm not showing it here, and this is a bit more standard. You're waiting for something to happen. So this is the program that goes with that. And again, this is a function that I've done the flowchart for, not the entire program. So the function here is named draw. So you'll start the initial terminator with the function name, which is draw. And then you would end here. Now if I had done the entire program, what would really happen would be that I would return to the main programming logic. But for this point, I'm just flowcharting this particular function. So I'm going to run this, and you'll see nothing happens until I click the mouse. So the way that it's programmed is if mouse pressed. What that really means is if mouse pressed equals equals true, this is the same thing. This is a shortcut in this program to just do mouse pressed. When you're doing a comparison, you always use two equal signs. The single equal sign is an assignment operator. And you'll see that it works the exact same way when I use if mouse pressed equals equals to true, works exactly the same as if mouse pressed. Processing basically gives you a little shorthand that represents that this is saying the mouse pressed is equal to true. And so that's the flowchart and the if statement.